Hey everyone, in this video, I want to show you how you could use the new Google form from start to finish. So first, let me show you how to get to the Google Forms. I basically went to google.com and looked for forms, and then it will take you to the Google suite right here. And forms is the last one, the one in purple. So it'll basically take you to this URL, and you have to say, go to Google Forms, and it will take you to Google Forms. And this is what it looks like. You do have to make sure you're signed into Google. So once you're signed in, you should see this page. And from this page, you could use a new document. So blank document, blank form, or you could use some of the templates that you already have here. And if you press this, you'll see a lot more options. So what Google Form is, it's a place where you could create a form and share it via Facebook, via email, embedded on a website, and get answers to your questions. So your questions could be a RSVP or a party invite. That could be a quiz if you're an educator. That could be a job application. Really anything where you could provide a question and you're looking for an answer, Google Form is a perfect free option that comes with Google Suite. And I want to show you how to create one from scratch right here. So go to the blank one. If you don't see one that fits your need on that templates, you could just create a new one. Here's a blank one for blank quizzes, but I'll just do a blank one from scratch. That's the first option. And this is your Google Form. The first time you come here, it's gonna ask you to take a tour, so you could take a tour. But let me show you how to set one up. So the first thing you wanna do is create a title. If I wanna do a customer survey and see if my customers are happy with my service. And then let's put the description. And the first question is, are you happy with our service? Let's say I'm using this for a business. So since I basically asked the yes or no question, is suggesting to me for the options to add all these yes, no, or maybe. So I'll say add all, or I could have done those individually. Let me just go ahead and delete these if I didn't want to do these to show you the other option. So option one, this would be option one, yes. I could individually do it. I could say add option. Option two is no, and then option three is maybe, just like the options it gave me. So now I have three options here, and if I want to change it from multiple choice, I do have other options like drop down or checkbox. Checkbox, for example, is going to make it look like this, or drop down is going to make it look like this. But for this video, I think multiple choice is the best option. And I'm done with my first question. But now if I wanted to add a second question, I'll have to go here on the side and press the plus sign here, and that will give me a second question. So then I could add a second question, and I could add my options here. And I have three options. I recommend having 3 to 4 options here, but there is really no limit on the number of options you could add. So you could have many options. So in this case, it's a yes or no. So that makes sense to have these three options, but you could add as many options as you want to these questions. And now one of the options I really like is being able to make an answer a required answer. So if you press that, this question is going to be a required question before you could add another question and move on in the quiz for the people taking the quiz. So let me turn that off. And if you want to duplicate a question or delete it, this is delete, this is duplicate. If you have a lot of text here, this might be a good way to duplicate and then not having to start from scratch. And then on the side here, you could add images, you could add videos. Let me go ahead and add an image here. You could upload an image, you could take a snapshot, you could take it from your Google Drive. Let me just go ahead and upload one. And it's gonna go with this question here, and I could title that image. And YouTube videos here, you could add that and add a URL or a YouTube video here. And the other option is to create another section. Let's say the first part is all about what the customer is thinking about your service, and the second part is all about the improvement. So press that, add a section. So now it's created a section one, and if you scroll down, there's a section two. So I could call this second section. And then I could add questions to that section. So this could be question one and so on. So now if you wanted to even customize it more, you would come up here and this color palette would give you some more options in changing the color. So if you didn't like the purple color, you could change it to any color you like. And let's say you didn't like any of these colors, you could choose the icon on the bottom and it will let you pick from some of these illustrations and pictures. Or you could do your own custom photo. So in this case, I was doing work and school, so I could scroll down and see which one fits best. So maybe this one, and I could just select that, and I would have a new look to my survey. Next, after customizing it, you could do a preview. So the second icon is preview, and it will show what other people are gonna see when they click on your quiz. This is what it looks like. So let me just go through this. So I'll say yes, video, next. And it should take me to the second question, and I'll press submit. And I'm gonna come back to Google Forms here. And let me just open my untitled form again. And I did it a couple of times when I was testing it out. So this is what it looks like when you get responses from other people. It's gonna give you a summary, or you could look at individual surveys and see exactly what their survey looked like, or your quiz or whatever your form may be. And up here under settings, I could just change some of the settings here. So if I was doing a quiz, I could just make this into a quiz and change some of these settings here. If I was a teacher, this was a great way to make a quiz, and I could either grade it or right after submission, I could give them the quiz score, and you could use it for presentation as well and show a progress bar of how much of the form is left. I'm gonna just press save here. And once everything is complete, the next step is just pressing send. And these are the options you have in sending this to people to get a response to your form, survey, quiz, or whatever your form may be. So you could either email it, you could just put multiple email addresses here, subject line message, just like any other email, or you could go here to the link and take this link and share it on Facebook. There's also social shares here, Twitter, Facebook, Google+. I just like to take it from here. You could even shorten it with Google URL shortener and just take this and put it on Facebook or Twitter or any social media platform. And if you want it on your website, there's an embed code here. So this is a great way to use it on your website to get answers from your customers, for example. So I was thinking about using this one that I'm gonna complete here to put on my website to get a survey from my current customers. And that's basically how you share Google Docs. So now if I go back to the main page in Google Form, I could see this form, and I could create folders if I had a lot of forms building up. And again, make sure you look at the template, because some of these, like this party invite here, it's a lot easier to start with these kind of templates than creating your own. So here you could just easily move these things around if you want to. So if I wanted this to be number one, I could move it around, and I could easily edit any of these questions or options or the way it's laid out, and I could customize it just like a blank form. I hope this video was helpful. Please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to this channel for a lot more tech tutorials and a lot more. Thanks for watching, and I hope to see you on the next video.